This is the question asked in today's SkillRack daily challenge. So we are given a string as an input and we have to print all the characters present in the string. And while printing the characters, if the character is a repeated character, then we have to print those characters in a new line. So let us see our sample input 1. Here the given input string is SkillRack. So let us start printing all the characters. The first character is S, so we print it as such, since it has not repeated now. And now the next character is K, and this is the first occurrence of K, so we print it. And then I, so I has also occurred for the first time, so we print it as such. And now the fourth character is L, so we print L. And now the fifth character is again L, so the character L has repeated for the first time, so we print the repeated character L in the new line. So the first character L has already printed, the second repeated L is printed in a new line, so we print it here. And now the next character is R, so the R has occurred for the first time, so we print it here. And now A, so A has also occurred for the first time, so we print it here. And now the character C has also occurred for the first time, so we print it here. And now the last character is K, but the character K has already occurred, so this is repeating, so we print this character K in a new line. So after printing C, we print a new line and print the character K. So this is how we get our output. Whenever a repeated character occurs, we print a new line and continue printing the characters. So this is the logic to solve the program. Now let us see how to write a C program for this. So first I am creating a character array named str of size 101 characters, and in the next line I am accepting the input in a string format and storing it into the character array str. And now I am creating a new integer array named frequency of size 128 and setting all the integers initial value to 0. So we will be using this integer array frequency to store the occurrence of every character present in the string str. And the size of this integer array is 128 because the ASCII value of all the characters ranges from 0 to 128. So whatever may be the input string and whatever may be its length, it can be made only with these 128 ASCII values. So that is why we are creating an integer array of size 128, and initially all of their occurrences will be 0. So that is why we are setting all the integers initial value to 0. So if we don't do this, then the initial value will be some garbage value. So in order to avoid that, we are setting all the values initially to 0. So now we have to print all the characters present in the string str. And whenever a repeated character occurs, we have to print a new line. So I am creating a for loop that iterates from 0 till string length of str. And in every iteration of this loop, we will be printing the character that is present in the string str, and we will also update its occurrence. Since we have printed a character, then we have to update its occurrence. So we will update our integer array frequency. So within the square brackets, we will be passing str of I. So the ASCII value of the particular character will be considered, and at that particular index of the integer array frequency, the value will be incremented by 1. So suppose if we are printing the character D, then at the respective ASCII value of the character D, the value will be updated to 1 from 0. So in every iteration after printing a character, we are updating its occurrence in the frequency integer array. And before performing this, we are also checking the frequency of the current character. So if the frequency of the current character is not equal to 0, then it means that the particular character has already been printed. So it is a repeated character, and whenever it is a repeated character, as per the question, we have to print a new line. So whenever the frequency of the particular character is not equal to 0, we are going to print a new line, and we are going to perform the same operation again. We will print the character. So after printing the character, we will update in our integer frequency array. So now let us check our program with sample test cases. So now I have given the sample input 1, and this is our expected output. So we also get the same. And now I have given the sample input 2, and this is our expected output. So we also get the same as our output. So this is the logic behind today's daily challenge. Thank you for watching.